Hallelujah. Please be seated. Let me tell you one thing. There are two sets of people in the kingdom and the church. There are one set of people that they want to see it before they thank God. And there are one set of people that will thank God even before they see. I dare somebody to be one of the people that walk by faith and not by sight. And go home today and say, Lord, I just want to thank you for awesome day. I just want to give glory to you for awesome day. I just want to make the enemy mad by awesome day. I just want to dance and praise your name for awesome day. I dare you to be one of those people that we go home dancing, that we go home rejoicing. I just want to thank you. This situation, you didn't have no room in my life again. You gave me my beauty for my arches. You gave me beauty for my arches. You take sorrow away and you gave me the oil of gladness. I want to thank you for awesome day in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Beloved, I want to read the word of God for you. The Lord asked me to tell you, to remind you. He said, just remind them this, for them to know that I do not lie. Ah, for those that believe me, there shall be a performance of the word that I gave to you. That awesome thing is going on with you and you and you today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Mighty name, we pray. Beloved, be seated for a minute. All that the Lord asked me to tell you in my conclusion is that verse 14 of Joshua 24, he said, now therefore, fear the Lord. He said, in all that I've sent to you today, in the conclusion of my word to you as a church, as my children, as my bride, fear the Lord and serve Him in sincerity. When I saw that, I said, what? The Bible talk about sincerity? I thought that was just English. He said, in sincerity, in sincerity, in sincerity. You may deceive the pastor. You can't deceive the Lord. You may deceive your sisters. You can't deceive the Lord. You may deceive your brother. You cannot deceive the Lord. You may deceive the apostle. You may deceive the bishop. You cannot deceive the Lord. He said, serve me in sincerity and in truth. In truth. In truth, in truth. Don't say, I don't have a new dress. I'm not going to church. Don't do that. Whatever you say, come to me as well. Beloved, when I first started church in those days in Queens, when I first came, I only have one skirt. And all I do is to change the blouse. Because I'm not going to sit home. Because some people are wearing a Armani suit. Because if I do that, I will not get to my destination. I will not be standing in your presence today. So I wasn't ignorant. I let whoever have their Armani suit wear their Armani suit. Because it is their turn. I know my own turn too is coming. So I know that the Lord will not forget me. If I pursue after Him, if I diligently seek Him. Yes, because He said, I am the Lord. I have a cattle of 10,000 hills. If I am hungry, I will not tell you. So I did not sit at home. People that have our money was wearing their money. I was wearing my gap skirt that my husband bought for me. I wear it every week. And all I do is to wear a t-shirt on top just to go to church. I didn't even see anybody. They are not my business. My business is the cross. Just let me see Jesus. As long as I can see Jesus, that is all I went for. And I was going to church. And I was believing. And I was expecting. And here we are today. If I go to my wardrobe, even some days I don't want to dress up. I just want to wear anything. That is God for you. And that is the awesome thing He's going to do in your life. In the name of Jesus. So if you sit down one day and say, that church, everybody, remember, Pastor BC says she was wearing one skirt too. So if the Lord did it for her then, I'm going. I'm going. Because my own time is coming.
Oh, yes. Amen.
What time is the best?
My own time is coming. And He said, put away the gods. And that is the God that I've just told you. All the jewelry, all the bling, bling, bling. Yes. Don't worry about all that. Pursue God for us. He said, do my force. And every other thing, I will add it unto you. I'm praying this year for a church that has zeal. A church that will not stay at home and say, a church that will know that, Lord, there is something that makes me come into your presence, my helper. It's not Pastor BC. It's not the apostle. It's you, Lord. It's you. It's you. Yeah, it's you. It's you. It's because of you I'm coming. They said, if I diligently seek you, you will give me the desires of my heart. And it's you I come for. It's you. Put away the gods which your father served on the other side of the flood. And when I got there, I stopped. And I said, Holy Spirit, what are you talking about? He said, you don't know that the reason why your father and your mother didn't really attain was because they didn't put their whole trust in me. They trust in other gods. When I speak, they don't even believe. They still go and check it out with their God. He said, that's why they never get to the promised land. Beloved, and I look at myself, I said, Lord, I want to get to my promised land. Everything you want me to do, I want to do it. If I don't sleep for 3 days, let it be. As long as what you want me to do, I do it. I obey the Lord to the core. Paul said, woe unto me if I didn't serve God. In other words, if I didn't, another person will. Another person will. If I walk out of here now, he will raise somebody up. He is the Lord. So who is anybody to think highly of themselves? Who? He said, they didn't believe me. They didn't believe me. And I was writing it down. Hear this. He said, you always said you don't want to be, you don't want to inherit the pattern and the life of your parents. You need to do your own life different so you don't end like your parents. As the Holy Spirit was talking, I was writing. And there are things that we've done years and years the same way. We need to change it now. We need to change it. The prophet said, look, enough of all this nonsense. If God is God, let us serve him. And if Baal is God, you can go to Baal. Let us know the difference here. It's the difference that our parents didn't know. They take Baal and God together and they are mixed up. But you are wise. Most of them didn't even go to school. So whatever they see is what they hear. Whatever they hear is what they do. But you can read and write. You have the Holy Spirit inside of you to explain things to you and show you the way and comfort you. Nobody comforted them but the Abbalists. They said, go and ask the Abbalist, let us throw the thing in the Abbalist pot and see what Ifa is saying or what the God is saying. But you don't do that. When you listen, you say, Holy Spirit, what is in the heart? And I begin to start and I begin to think and I said, oh, we should appreciate God more. Because when our parents go to Abbalist, they give money. Right?
Yes. More than money. They gave
good. Good clothes.
But God didn't take nothing. He said, I gave you all something. I'm not taking nothing. I just gave it to you. Because you are my children. Awesome day. All the good that God did for you and me. If it was you, you would have paid dollars from me. You would have said, Pastor BC, pay $100. Pastor BC, for that bread that you just take, pay me $300. But God didn't take nothing. He gave everything free.
Amen.
Isn't that God deserve to be praised? Isn't that God deserve to be served? Isn't that God deserve to be feared? Hallelujah. Beloved, as I close this sermon, I want you to go home with awesome day. This week, everything that your thoughts bring must be awesome day. Awesome day. Every negative, get out. I don't want to hear. No negative, no negative. No negative. Don't abort what the Lord has given me. All that he said to me is what I'm looking for. He said he will show me sign this way of my awesome day. And that's what I believe. And that's what I'm expecting. Nothing less. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, Lord, we say thank you. Forever we are grateful. Oh, God, Jesus. Thank you for visiting your people. Thank you for doing exceedingly abundantly more than what we can even do. Thank you for awesome deeds that eyes have not seen, that ears have not heard. Thank you for awesome deeds that have never entered into the heart of man. We praise you now and we will forever thank you because you have been so good. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.